Hey guys, welcome to another video. I wanted to start by thanking all of you for the support for my last video. Now it's Christmas Eve here in Italy, and we're gonna go to my best friend's place to record some stuff, to see him and record. You're probably gonna see that in the next video. It's quite interesting, I think, so stay tuned for that and let's go.
Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun.
Hey guys, Merry Christmas. It's Christmas Day now here in Italy. And yesterday at my best friend's place, I filmed something, but you're probably gonna be seeing that in the maybe the next video, maybe even after, because there's quite a lot of editing towards that video that I'm gonna make, but it's gonna be really good. So yeah, I'm here with my sister.
Hi guys.
And we're just going to our grandparents for Christmas Day lunch. And yeah, so I'll bring you with me, then we'll probably go to see my best friends again and a few other friends tonight, and my dad's place, so with dogs and stuff. It's gonna be really cool.
It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in the one horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock.
Fast forward a few days now, we got a busy day today. We're going into the office, which is a really nice co-working space. Let me get there, I'll show it to you. It's a nice co-working space here in Vicenza, and here we go. As I was saying, it's really a nice co-working space here in Vicenza. I come here often to work. As you can see, it's really spacious. If you want to check it out, if you're from Vicenza, it's called MIT Co-working Center on Facebook. Here we are setting up something really cool that you're going to be seeing probably really late April or May. So as I was saying, we got here everything set up, so we need to do this. It's going to take at least a couple of hours. Then I got a really important call 5 p.m. with potential partnership for my personal training business, and that is really important. And then after that we're gonna be done, so we got at least 3 to 4 hours here today, and then we are gonna have a chat about our 2018, what has been 2018 for me, and you know, kind of end it. This is gonna be the last video 2018 for me. So yeah, we're gonna do that and I'll catch you soon. So here we are, guys, talking about our 2018 and how it went. And by the way, this mic is not working. The microphone on top of the camera is working instead. This is for the other project. It's a bit more professional. And so I usually like doing goal settings and I recommend it to everyone. It has helped me a lot. So I always write down, whether it's on my phone, on my laptop, or even like on a piece of paper, all my goals and my expectations for whether it's gonna be weekly, monthly, yearly, or even daily. I do not recommend the daily one because in my opinion, it's just a waste of time in terms of I would think about them rather than writing them, because it just takes too much time. But on weekly, monthly, and yearly, I really like doing that and it can help a lot. And if you want to start it out, please do so. And make sure to write down the most important one on the top and the least important one at the bottom, so that you can know which one to prioritize when you're faced with that choice to make. So what has it been 2018 for me? For me, 2018 has been a really, really difficult year because I had to work a lot, keep it a low profile. And in fact, most of the businesses I'm involved in have been set up in 2018. So I had to work really, really hard on them, and I had to keep them really private. And at this point in time, most of them are still private or known to just a few people around me. But I kind of enjoyed it. It's been a year of change. I'm approaching graduation in 2019, so I have a lot going on, and I have to set up everything from after graduation for what I'm gonna do. So basically, this has been my 2018, full of good memories and bad memories as well. In terms of achievements and not achievements, my goals for 2018, I had many, but I did not manage to achieve them all, I'll say. The first one, the most important one I set myself to achieve, I didn't manage to achieve, for example. And it was something about one of my businesses that I wanted to grow and make public and make a big thing. And I haven't been able to do so as yet, but you will know more about it in the future because it's still not really public. I'm kind of sorting all the problems I had now, so in the upcoming month, hopefully, it will be all public, and I will explain to you why I did not achieve that and what were the problems. And the other goal that I did not achieve, it's about stretching. I know it sounds really stupid or silly or whatever, but I set myself a goal to be able to like stretch down to the ground every time I wanted to, and that is still not happening. And yeah, so I kind of neglected that in the past few months. I've been progressing, but not as much as I should have done. And in the gym wise, if you're interested, I've been able to achieve all the liftings I wanted to achieve in terms of numbers. So I was really, really happy about it. And in terms of clients, my first few clients achieved their goals, and that is something I'm really proud of. And so basically 2018 is ending on a good note, I have to say. In the past month or two, I really enjoyed achieving the goals, because most of my goals have been achieved at the end really of the year. And yeah, so try out the listing if you want for 2019, or even for like just January or whatever you want, and let me know how it goes. And thank you so much for watching. I want to wish you a happy new year, and I'll see you at the next video.